Inside Skyhawk Football with Coach Jason Simpson. Coach, this past weekend, Southeast Missouri, the opponent. We opened Ohio Valley Conference play with a win. Nice victory.
Well, you know, it's certainly nice to get that first victory under our first conference victory under our belt. And thought we did some good things. And, you know, luckily we got still some things we can correct going into this week. But as you can see, right off the practice field, and we had a good work today. So looking forward to this upcoming game.
Coach, we're going to watch the game film in just a minute, though. But how competitive will the OVC be this year, do you think?
Well, I don't think I think every game will be a fourth quarter game that we play. There won't be, you know, any blowouts. I think the talent is that comparable, and it'll come down to turnovers, special teams, and you know, probably whoever's quarterback is playing the best that day.
Yeah. And even recently, you mentioned every game being a fourth quarter game. These scores have been close when the conference teams have played each other, even if you thought it might be lopsided.
Well, you do, because I think it's sometimes you play a little bit more conservative once you've got the lead, because you don't want, you know, mistakes to come back and bite you. And that's certainly kind of, you know, it's been our play calling motive. So, you know, we'll take it as a 1-point win or 30-point win. They all count the same.
Okay. Let's look at the game film. It was a beautiful day at Graham Stadium. Tennessee Martin taking on Southeast Missouri. Southeast Missouri taking on UT Martin at Graham Stadium. Beautiful day, Coach. A great atmosphere. The temperature was just perfect.
It really was. What a beautiful day. And a little cloudy that morning, and blue skies came out, and I like it with his blue skies and blue jerseys.
And the coin toss of captains out there. Oddly enough, in this game, the wind kind of picked up late.
It sure did.
Surprised.
I thought some rain was going to come there after the first half.
And here's the kickoff.
You got to get the ball inside the 5-yard line there. We need that deep kick left.
Southeast Missouri making the move and stop there right about the 20.
Nice play by Kendall Harper from Trenton Peabody here in West Tennessee. Good physical tackle. He's playing really well for us. He's a sophomore, so got some experience and some years to come under his belt.
And Peoples with the rush.
Little option play there. We wasn't ready for it out of that particular personnel. They caught us in a bad cover two look right there, and it kind of puts us in a bind.
Scheibel, the quarterback, with a complete pass.
You know, they were playing really fast at this time, and you know, as soon as the official would spot the ball, they were snapping it, and they had a good game plan coming in.
This time, quarterback keeps the football.
Yeah, we missed a tackle there by Trey Smith, number 37, and you know, now we're still getting pursued, and we're getting there, not luckily knocking him out of bounds, but we've got to tackle better.
This is Southeast Missouri, right out of the gun, getting it in the end zone.
You know, running just a little fade route there by Aaron High, and you know, we knew it was coming, we couldn't stop it, so. You know, defense got to adjust, and luckily they did the rest of this half.
Point after was no good, and Southeast Missouri strikes first, leading it in the first quarter, 6-0.
Really worked hard in our kickoff return unit this week, and you know, put some starters in our units. We say special teams are important to us, so we put some starters, and there's Jason McNair, and making one guy miss, and you know, getting it out there, you know, about the 26, 27 yard line, and anytime you can get past 25, you know, it's a pretty good return.
He is good at making players miss. Here's Miguel Barnes.
You know, good little toss play there out of a bunch formation. You know, get it to second five, and Miguel's getting downhill, and we like that when we get guys pulling and running.
Barnes again.
You know, nice physical run there. Safety does a good job, and the late hit, and it adds on. Now, there's a little wildcat package for us. You know, and a lot of teams use this now, and you'll see Jason McNair at the quarterback position, a little, you know, block down, kick out, and, you know, it gives you an extra back in the backfield because now your quarterback is the ball carrier.
Third and nine situation. Here's Kay Thompson letting it fly.
You know, just I wish we'd gone to our tight end there on our third down, and the ball kind of comes off of Unique's leg there.
Skyhawks punt the football.
You know, like great kick there, but I see Joe pin them back inside the 10.
The Southeast Missouri quarterback, Scheibel.
You know, he's a good little physical player, and they've got a little option scheme going. It's hard to defend. You know, you got to get them to some third and mediums, third and longs.
Henry Harris will pick up 2 yards here. Good stop by the Skyhawks.
Nice play by Jed Howard. This was probably his best football game as a Skyhawk. He's from Arkansas, as a sophomore for us.
Incomplete pass here.
You know, good coverage, good pressure. You like to see that when the quarterback's having to throw it out of bounds.
Skyhawks back with the football against Southeast Missouri, leading its first quarter 6-0 to score.
Nice little toss, crack toss for us there. Miguel, you know, doesn't look like much, but you know, it's a gain of 6 or 7, gets you to a second down and manageable down and distance there.
Miguel will hit the 100-yard plus mark again today in this game.
You know, nice play. We stacked the receivers up out there. They didn't bump out to cover us. And, you know, it's just like an extended handoff for us.
Kay Thompson again for the Skyhawks.
I believe this is one that actually the tailback, Miguel Barnes, had a bust assignment with, went the wrong way, and we had to take the short throw and instead of the deeper throw, which was open, and it cost us a first down there.
Skyhawks punt the football. Here's Henry Harris for Southeast Missouri.
Nice little play on the option, and it's a big gainer for them.
Scheibel, the quarterback now for Southeast, with the pass to Stewart.
A little bubble screen in the flat. Luckily, made a bad throw.
Third and three, here's a big play.
That is a nice play there by Jett. Like I said, very active, very athletic guy. When we play in our three down package, he's able to get a lot of playing time, and he gives us a lot of energy out there.
Looks like Bill Russell for the Boston Celtics on that one. Look at his kick.
You know, guy's got plenty of leg, just pulled a little bit to the left. They certainly got some good specialists there at Southeast Missouri.
Skyhawks back with it, first and 10, Kay Thompson to Mike Hicks.
You know, we run a little little dig up here, and it's good to see Mike back out there. And you see the knee sleeve on him there. He's not 100%, but he's giving good effort.
Second and 10, big pickup for Barnes.
You know, nice runoff tackle there. Our center, Quinn Groves, does a great job. And Joe Gibbs just outstanding all night at that right tackle position.
And again, Barnes, look at him hitting that hole.
Nice little power play. We get the double team by Michael Mancini, got his first start at guard and thought he did a really good job there. Mancini is on the pool there, number 53, and real proud of his effort for his first start. And we'll go back and look at this one. You'll see this is just our little stretch play. And the tackle does a great job, Rodney Irvin here, of getting expansion from this defensive end.
What do you mean an expansion, Coach?
Well, you'll see him, he's a reach block, okay? So he's trying to get his helmet to the outside number. All right, and the back is reading this. If Rodney can reach this and have our color outside of this color, then the ball will go outside. If this guy keeps, defensive end keeps his hat outside, we use a torque technique, which will be strong with our inside arm, and torque the defender out, and the ball will cut up inside. Our track to the back is 1 yard outside of the in-man line of scrimmage here. And you'll see this one work to perfection. He torques it with the inside arm, there's the expansion, and good hit by the safety there. But when you can get that play going, a lot of good play action come off of it.
Brandon Young there on the run, and the Skyhawks still trailing 6-0, but Tennessee Martin's set to have a big second quarter.
And a nice little bubble screen, got to do a better job out there in the perimeter blocking. Those little passes can turn into big gains.
Brandon Young again, who's been out most of the season with a hamstring injury.
A little off tackle power play there. Getting some good push.
Second and 6, Miguel Barnes.
Here we go. Here's the same little stretch play. We motion the receiver over. He blocks the force player. We stretch it, insert the fullback. You know, and once again, that safety's coming down. But will he want to do it for four quarters is the question.
Barnes finding a rhythm.
A little short yardage play. We're able to get the first down and extend the drive.
And then Barnes one more time. Uncontested, we'll take it into the end zone. How do you get there, Coach?
Well, this is why Joe Gibbs is a preseason All-American. You know, you either reach this guy or you stretch him and torque him. And watch Joe Gibbs, the reach, he pins it inside, you know, and just seals us an edge, and we're able to get to the outside.
Skyhawks get the point after, and Tennessee Martin will take the lead 7-6 as Barnes with another touchdown for Tennessee Martin this season and a kick. Look at that shot of Bob Carroll's building. Skyhawks leading at 7-6. And, Coach, you had to feel like you'd gotten the momentum back after a tough first quarter.
Well, it certainly felt like that. And, you know, we're starting to do some things good defensively and rallying and running the ball. And, seems to have a good plan and good execution going.
Scheibel with a couple of passes there. And on a 4th-and-5 situation, they'll punt the football.
You know, Millie probably should have let that one go, see if it had gone in the end zone. But we come out here, Dexter's got to stretch that a little bit more. Does a nice job of running after the catch, but we need to try to get that outside of the blocking receiver.
Okay, looking for Dexter again.
Nice job here on the little third down conversion. We've got a combination route out here, whether we're running a curl flat or a high-low combination, and then we'll drag the first receiver on the opposite side underneath our tight end. So as the backers, if they don't expand, we can work our combination routes over here. If the backers do expand, then the quarterback can come back down to his drag route, to his tight end, back to his back. Dexter does a good job making the first guy miss, getting north and south, and able to convert a nice little short throw into a first down.
Dexter getting 9 catches on the day. Here's Brandon Young.
You know, nice stretch play again, good blocking on the perimeter, and it's good to see number 5 back out there.
And again on this drive, Kay Thompson.
Once again, you see our center and our guard doing a nice job. We knew the blitz was coming from the field, So the shade, the nose tackle's coming out, and our guard and tackle did a great job.
Look at this play, and look at the arm of Kay Thompson.
Well, you can't really see a great view of it here, but we set this up by running a little toss play earlier out of this, so we gave it a heavy run flavor. And you'll see here our tight end and our receiver here. We're crossing the face there, the safety. And one's crossing in front, and one's expanding out, then breaking it over the top on the high shelf post, and good execution all the way around.
Skyhawks with the touchdown, one of three in the second quarter. Right on the money from Cade to Dexter and Noka.
You like those, you get those big chunks.
And the point after will be good as the Skyhawks take the lead 14-6, still in the second quarter at Graham Stadium.
Starting to build a little momentum here. Guys are starting to feel good about themselves. And, you know, we just need to play mistake-free football, and we can be a pretty good offensive team.
Southeast back with it. There's the quarterback going for 2 yards.
Nice job. We came into the game wanting to stop the quarterback draw, and that was emphasis all week. And our defensive staff and our players did a great job taking that away for the most part of the game.
This time he lets it fly under some pressure.
Yeah, almost lost contain there, but did a nice job for Josh Cody rallying and getting back up on the quarterback.
And their punter will punt it to us.
You know, trying to pin us deep and kind of shanks a little bit out of bounds and gives us decent field position. Got a little screen play going on here. This is a double screen, which means we're reading this defensive end. And as you'll see here, if the defensive end is up the field, we'll take the screen and get the tackle out. If he turns and runs with the back, we'll come to the backside screen, which is a inverted screen with our wide receivers. Okay, did a nice job on the read there.
Getting it to Miguel Barnes.
Good job, zone blitz right there. Saw it coming and was able to capitalize on the run play.
Skyhawks still with it.
Back to the screen. We didn't have a front side, so we come to backside. And of course, my heart jumped like yours did when Mike jumps over the guy, but it's good to see him competing and getting a little competitive. You know, like I said, I don't know if he'll be 100% the whole year, but he's trying to play through some things.
This time, Cade finding Dexter and Noka.
Same type of combination route, take the easy throw on the little drag route, and Dexter doing a good job using his speed.
First down, Skyhawks. Brandon Young.
A little draw play. Nice job.
Kay Thompson finding the receiver, Unique Williams.
Yeah, Unique does a nice job here, and it's good to see Kay move around in the pocket and find the open man, and that's one thing we've emphasized with him is that, you know, if throw's not there on rhythm, move around the pocket. It's okay to, you don't have to be a runner, but make some plays with your feet and keep your eyes downfield, and receivers keep working, getting the open areas.
First down on the 18-yard pickup for the Skyhawks, now Brandon Young.
All right, we go back to the stretch play, and like I said, that number nine for them made a lot of good hits at the safety, but you know, our backs were being real physical.
Brandon Young again, this time for a first down.
Good little off tackle, and Brandon used a good vision, didn't block it extremely well. Brandon's able to roll the ball back, and you know, when you got a fresh back in there, that's kind of what happens.
Miguel Barnes.
Good job making the corner miss there and picking up extra yardage.
And Miguel, who got one in the end zone earlier, will do it one more time.
You know, you see receivers blocking there and being physical, and you know, guys stretch out, getting the goal line, that's a good feeling right there.
Tennessee Martin gets the point after. Coach, 21 points in the second quarter.
Well, you know, we're very capable of that. We just, like I said, got to quit being our own worst enemy.
And the Skyhawks take that lead 21-6 after trailing 6-0 out of the gate, and just hoping to hold them down for the rest of the first half.
You know, we get a penalty, we come out in the second half, and we're not able to capitalize, pick up a first down, and they get the ball back and start making a few plays and changing field position on us.
In Southeast Missouri, looking to make something, get it going here.
You know, nice pressure. Chris Murray needs to come up with that sack right there. I think he had one on the night, but you know, he's capable of so much more, and I guess that's for the first half there. And he's capable of so much more, and you know, hopefully if he can take good angles, you know, he can be a 10-sack guy for the season.
21-6, the halftime score. Tennessee Martin gets the ball to start the third quarter.
You know, good little return there by Jason, gets it out there to about the 40-yard line. I mean, that's all you can ask for. You only need, you know, 40 more yards to get in field goal range. So we emphasize that unit, and you know, like I said, we had a penalty. We come back and run a little power play out of the gun, and you know, for a minimal gain, but when you're off cycle, come back to a little screen backside, and they played it pretty well, and So we end up having to punt.
Shiver there with the catch. It's time to Milligan.
You know, need to try to find ways to get Milligan ball in his hands, and you know, just wasn't one of those nights that we were, you know, really airing it out.
Here's the Skyhawk punt. Southeast Missouri back with it, trailing 21-6 in the third quarter.
Number 15 is a pretty good player for them. I'm
Walter Peoples.
You know, I don't know about this. We get after the quarterback here. You know, but, you know, like I see Jamar just pull his hands up there. Wasn't really a very physical hit, but the officials are really protecting the quarterbacks. Nice play there by I believe that's Eddie Morgan on the backdoor screen there.
Long kick.
Here we go. Hit the goal post, and now, you know, they 51 yarder there, and you know, gave them new life to get points on the board. Now it's 21-9 game.
Tennessee Martin will get it back, as coach said, 21-9, and Southeast Missouri did not go away after the Skyhawks scored three touchdowns in the second quarter.
We didn't show it here, but bad decision trying to bring the ball out of the end zone there. Jason McNair, redshirt freshman, and you know, luckily we get a couple first downs here. Run this play into blitz, and Miguel does a nice job of you know, kind of making something out of nothing.
I think we're going to watch it again here, Barnes on the pickup.
Yeah, I mean, you see number four, he blitzed us, he fooled the quarterback, and he's unblockable. So guess what, the back's got to make him miss, and you don't want to live in too many situations like that.
Barnes one more time for the Skyhawks.
Yeah, we get the third and four and run a little off this little stretch play again, and their safety did a nice job.
Joe Hook with a punt for 50 yards.
You know, good job changing field position for us, Joe, and kicking the ball down there, and you know, we need to pin him up a little bit better.
Southeast Missouri looking to get more points on the board as they start the drive at the 28-yard line.
You know, throwing the little bubble screen, and you know, you can't take away the curl and the little screen, and so we chose to take away the curl and rally back to the back.
Shibble, the quarterback, with another complete pass.
You know, missed tackle there. I mean, usually on screens, usually you'll see that, even for us, usually you don't make very many blocks on screens. You just got people missing tackles, and that's what happened there.
This time the quarterback will run the football. And then I thought a big defensive play here coming up for the Skyhawks.
You know, penalties hurt them as well. We had 12, they had 14.
And we got to him.
There we go. Good job, Chris Murray, getting the sack, and that was big for us.
Would not let go. Southeast forced to punt the football now. Back to Tennessee Martin, still in the third quarter.
Yeah, I mean, a little disappointing here. We have a chance to, you know, kind of, you know, they luckily kick in the end zone. We have a chance to, you know, make some bigger plays down the field here, change field position, and possibly put them away at this point. And, you know, wasn't quite able to do it. Nice job by Jason making a guy miss there. Not a great play into that look. And he's able to, you know, not very many times does Jason McNair get tackled by the first guy.
Very crafty with his footwork.
Yeah, got great footwork.
McNair this time is going to pick up 9 yards.
You know, nice little power play there, and you know, you always come out of the game wishing that Jason would have touched the ball a little bit more.
Kay Thompson's going to let it fly.
Nice there by Jason. We snuck him in there at fullback and threw a little route to him, a vertical seam, and you know, just nice play by their safety, and you know, just big hit there, and knocks the ball loose. I mean, you can't fault a guy for that. It's a physical game, and you know, things happen. Number 9, like I said, is a good player, and put his hat on the ball, and you get the knock loose.
Southeast back with it. Pretty good field position.
Yeah, this is pretty disappointing right here. We had bad fits on the little power play, and their back does a good job here. They block it well, and you know, most of that is because we were not aligned correctly.
21-9 that score as we hit the fourth quarter.
You know, they got a little bubble slant on us right here, and they're executing.
Shibble this time looking for Peoples again.
You know, just taking what the defense gives him and, you know, making runs, 12-yard runs after the catch.
Mike Jones with the carry.
You know, same power play again, off tackle, and you know, that's not what we want to be. Now, I am proud of this. We give great effort on the low kick here, and you never know when that 1 point could change the game. And, you know, it keeps it to a 6 point game to where they've at least got to make two field goals, you know, to tie us, okay? And, you know, in play calling, that can be big.
Kendall Harper. So the Skyhawks leading it now 21-15, still in the fourth quarter, and Tennessee Martin back with the football. Here's Cade Thompson.
We go back to the play action again, and you know it's a nice throw, but just wasn't able to connect, but it's a good place to miss.
And intended for Unique Williams.
You know, this was one of the throws that I wish Cade could have got back. We run the four vertical, and you know, he works to the number three, the inside receiver, and if you had a wider view, you would see that the other receiver has got the cleaner catch.
Southeast back with it.
Hey, we get a fumble right here, and of course, it gives us a personal foul here. We're just excited and, you know, jumped up a little bit too excited, and the official flagged us there, unsportsmanlike.
Brandon Young with the Skyhawk carry for 6 yards.
You know, the same off-tackle play there, and, you know, our guys are running. Great job by Quentin Groves there, and, you know, our backs run hard, but we got to come out of some of these tackles if we're going to have some big runs.
Cade Thompson to Anoka.
You know, you'll see there, I thought that was a, you know, very close call there. They get Mike Hicks for the holding call.
Cade with a hard hit there.
Yeah, and you'll see there, and here's what happened, and Cade does a nice job of being tough to stand in that pocket, but we got a 7-man protection to where the offensive tackle has the down lineman here, the offensive guard has the down lineman here, our center guard and backside tackle are sliding back, blocking 1, 2, 3. Our fullback has this one, our tailback has this linebacker. And you'll see our fullback sees him coming, our tailback doesn't, and it almost gets our quarterback, runs right past him. BY is a great pass protector, and you always got to be ready. They don't blitz a whole lot. They probably only blitz probably 10 times out of 73 plays, but the one time that you take your eyes off your responsibility, I believe I heard, you know, we got the head-to-helmet call. I think I heard Cade say that Brandon Young told him he'd take him to lunch today. He owed him one.
Skyhawks back with it to Kenny Jones.
Nice little play action. Cade had actually missed this play earlier, and I was able to come back and find the fullback there, and that was a big, little play action for us to give us some relief there.
And uh-oh.
Yeah, this is a play here to where, you know, Mike and Cade really had a chance to work together a whole lot with Mike being, you know, injured, and you know, you like our chances with Mike Hicks in end zone on the little fade route. Cade kind of left this one a little short, and the corner actually makes a really nice play. But that ball's got to be 4 yards inside the back pylon and something that Mike Hicks can jump for and body up.
Southeast Missouri back with it, trailing 21-15 within a touchdown of tying this game up.
You know, that's a really good play by Jonathan Utley on the scrape by the linebacker on the power play.
Quarterback, incomplete pass.
Nice job by a marquee guy. He was a player of the game for us on defense, and I believe he played every snap on defense, him and Josh Bay both did.
Back with it, Cade Thompson.
Nice little play in the flat. You know, and sometimes these plays only turn into 3 and 4 yard gains, but they help your run game when you're able to make some throws like that out of two back.
Here's Miguel Barnes again, who had a busy day.
Yeah, like I said, doesn't look like much, but that's a 6 and 7 yard gain, and that starts wearing that defense out when they're having to run sideline to sideline.
Barnes again. And you're controlling the clock too, Coach.
Exactly. You know, you're only up by 6 at this point. You want to sustain a drive and make sure you get some points out of it.
Cade Thompson to Anoka.
Nice job on the little crossing package, and got to stay past that down marker there.
Cade Thompson.
You know, nice job here, and you'll see this is off of play action. We had set this up. We're waiting until we got on the right hash. All right, so, you know, Kenny Jones is in at the tight end, and you knew off this run action that the linebacker was going to step down. And by doing this, here's the safety. The other safety's on the other side of the field, bracketed in this receiver. So there's nobody behind this linebacker. He has that tight end and man coverage. And you'll see there, he peeks it, lets him run past him, and the other safety's on the opposite hash. So great concentration by Kenny.
Yeah, juggled it once and brought it right in.
You know, Kenny's got great ball skills, and last year he was our fullback, this year he's our fullback, and he's playing tight end for us, and that's a hard act to do. That's great concentration.
Skyhawks first and 10, this time giving it to Brandon Young.
You know, going back to the power play. And, you know, like I said, that's just physical football. Everybody in the country can draw that power play up. But when you execute it, it gets guys excited. You see Rodney Irvin and Brandon Young, and that's what we want it to be like.
Brandon Young, one more time.
Brandon does a great job on the goal line because he gets his pads down. He really runs a good body lean. You see him keeping his feet moving. And as we tell our offensive linemen, get your feet in the end zone, because if they're in the end zone, then the back's going to be able to be in the end zone.
Touchdown, Skyhawks, and a big one that kind of gave us some separation on that scoreboard.
Some good push. Look at all those blue jerseys, and that's what you like to see.
And then you go for two here, Coach.
Go for 2 points here to make it a two-score game, and we run a little sprint out, a little pick action, and Caden Dexter hook up, and that was a nice play.
29-15 on the two-point conversion. Tennessee Martin taking the lead, Southeast Missouri. You see Dexter Anoka, who obviously is pleased with that play. And the Skyhawks leading it, just needing to get some stops now.
Try to run a little fake reverse right here. We cover it pretty good, but you know they need a big play, and there's good coverage there by Marquis, you know, even though we got the flag, but, you know, he's running step for step.
And there's the call by the official. And the quarterback, Scheibel, this time the pass complete. That's to Miles Edwards. Southeast knows they need to score and need to score quickly.
You know, you like seeing the quarterback having to move. That was, you know, bang, bang call right there. It's on their sideline, and unfortunately we didn't get the call. You know, bang, bang. So hopefully we'll get that call on our sideline.
Big defensive play, Tennessee Martin.
You know, Josh Bay gets called for the face mask here. You know, he put his hands on it. You'd like to think, you know, they didn't grab the quarterback by it, but, you know, you see the fingers go on the face mask, and that's a penalty.
Again, Southeast Missouri truly needs to score in there. You're talking to the official.
I'm just asking, was he sure?
Yeah.
100% sure, because yeah. I was going to see the tape on Sunday. Got to make that tackle there, Josh. But what great effort. He misses the tackle, gets up, runs it back down. He's just a good player.
And they get into the end zone. So Southeast Missouri staying alive.
I thought we got a little bit lax here. You know, I thought maybe our players thought we'd put the game away, but Southeast Missouri give them credit. And got a chance here to get the ball back and even take the lead. And there's Derek Carr. Nice job, our backup quarterback, going out there and, you know, making a courageous play, and you know you're going to get hit, and you jump up and you cradle the ball, and you know, you'll see it here, and he knows he's going to take a whack here, and that's a nice job, good, you know, unselfish play on his part by giving his body up and help secure the win.
Well, a big play, certainly one of the biggest plays of the game right there. And Tennessee Martin will have it back with a chance to control the clock. Here's Miguel Barnes.
Well, we're running a little off-tackle play. The play's been running all night, and it was a good call by the official. We hailed him, and, you know, we've got to learn to keep our hands inside the body frame.
Brandon Young.
At this point, you know, we're not going to throw a pass. We're just trying to run a clock here, make them use their timeouts, so when they do get the ball back, they don't have any more timeouts.
And Skyhawks will punt the football.
You know, good kick here. Spots it there at the 2-yard line, and you know, so now they got to go 98 yards. Not real sure about that call, but we'll take it right there. You know, his momentum took him in, but he beanbagged it, and we'll certainly take it.
Southeast really having to do something in a hurry, getting out of bounds there. Scheibel completes the pass.
Yeah, you know, just keep it in front of you. You know, rally and tackle. Don't go for the interception, knock the ball down. Justin Dard did a nice job getting after the quarterback. Played about 25 plays for us and was able to give us some good quality minutes.
And that pretty much wrapped it up there.
Great play by Aaron High right here, and I'm just going to show you that one. And this is a fifth-year senior here being unselfish. You know, he's got some green grass here, but there is one or two defenders here. And, you know, the score does no good, but what would keep the game going is if he fumbles this football and they get one more shot. So very proud of his unselfishness there, and that's good to see a fifth-year senior there, you know, in the game, the ball in his hands.
We'll watch it one more time.
I'm not so sure. You might would have tried to score, but you see
definitely.
The quarterback coming. And,
Now, if he was on the other side and the coaching staff wouldn't have been yelling at him.
So, but that's good to see, doing what he's coached to do, and And it's fun when you see your players listen to coaching and execute it.
And a final score, Tennessee Martin wins at 29-22 over Southeast Missouri. It was the conference opener for the Skyhawks. Look at the conference standings now. Eastern Illinois at 2-0, Eastern Kentucky 2-0, UT Martin 1-0, Tennessee State yet to play a conference game. Then you got Tech, Austin Peay, and Murray State 0-1, Southeast Missouri 0-2. And Coach, you have said that this is going to be a competitive conference this year.
Well, I mean, you see there, East Illinois, Eastern Kentucky, I mean, they can beat anybody in the country. Tennessee Tech yet to play a conference opponent, and so we really don't know a whole lot about them. But, I know this, the opponent we're going to play this week is a very quality opponent. It's the best Jacksonville State team we've played in our 4 years here, so we've got our hands full.
And Skyhawks win this past Saturday over Southeast Missouri, 29-22. Skyhawks get a win over Southeast Missouri. Coach Simpson, it does not get easy. It's a tough road schedule for Tennessee Martin all year. This might be one of the most challenging of them all going to Jacksonville State.
It is, and I think, they'll be the best team we played. And that's, very comparable to the Memphis team we just got through playing. And I mean that sincerely. Their quarterbacks, their wide receivers, the defensive tackle transfer from Florida, a lot of talent on that field. Luckily, our kids don't know any better. They know they've won two out of the last 3 years against Jacksonville, so we'll go play hard and hopefully come back with a victory.
It's a cool place to play, and you spent some time there, but they have a great football atmosphere.
They do. I was there for 3 years as an assistant. They've got good tradition there. There'll be a good crowd. It's their first home game, so that's why you play this game. They're playing those type of atmospheres, and so both teams be ready, and it'll be good competition.
There are a million ways to get from Martin, Tennessee to Jacksonville, Alabama. Now, we always promise you on the internet show you get to learn something that you wouldn't normally or ordinarily get to see. Coach, if you were going to your car right now and I told you it was like the Amazing Race, the reality show, and you had to get to Jacksonville State as quickly as you possibly could, how would you go?
Oh, that's a great question from here. I know the easiest way.
Okay.
I don't know about that,
okay.
But I would go through, I'd go to Nashville or go to Huntsville and go down. No, I take that back. I would go to Nashville and go down.
Okay. Down 65.
There you go. And stay on that. And hopefully you're driving so I can sleep.
Okay. Because some people actually go through Chattanooga, which is...
You kind of go that way through Murfreesboro there. Mm-hmm. So I don't know. Just I know the name of the stadium is Paul Snow Stadium. The ball will kick off at 1:00. So and we'll be there ready.
They'll be there on time. Let's take a helicopter, Coach. I bet we could get there. Join us next week again for Inside Skyhawk Football with Coach Jason Simpson. Thanks for watching.